Good afternoon. I am Niraj Bhadresha from Atmiya Engineering College. Today we are discuss about some importance problem of the unit number 3 in GTU syllabus, that is differentiation and its application. This is our first schedule for differentiation and its application. So we move to very importance problem of the differentiation and its application. So we move to our next question. Here f of x equal to f of x, and you want to find the dy by dx. This is the very basic formula, so we write it first. Dy by dx, and here f of x, any value we want to find with differentiation. Then suppose f of x equal to k, then we want to find the dy by dx. This is called dk by dx equal to 0. So this is the rule. Here f of x, here dy by dx. When input, that is k, we can say the differentiation of the constant, that's called 0. Same way, when f of x is equal to x raised to n, we can say the differentiation of x raised to n equal to n x raised to power minus 1, that's called n minus 1. So another rule, when x raised to n, that is our input, the differentiation, that is n x raised to n minus 1. Same way, suppose e raised to x, then we can say that the differentiation of the e raised to x, that is as it is, that is e raised to x. Now next one, that is suppose log x, if input, or you can say f of x equal to log x, then differentiation of the log, that's called d by dx of log x equal to 1 upon x. So this is nothing but some of the basic rule that we want to follow entire sum, that is log x differentiation, that is 1 upon x, e raised to x differentiation, that is e raised to x raised to n differentiation, that is n x raised to n minus 1, and constant value, that called 0. Now new value, suppose a raised to x, then differentiation of a raised to x, that is nothing but a raised to x as it is, then put log a. So differentiation of a raised to x, that is a raised to x log a. Now next value, that is suppose sin x, some trigonometric differentiation, sin x differentiation, that is cos x, cos x differentiation, that is minus sin x, tan x differentiation, that is sec square x, and cot x differentiation, that is minus cos x square x. Same way, we want to expand some of the another trigonometric rule, that is suppose sec x differentiation, that is sec x into tan x, and last one, that is cosec x, and differentiation of cosec x, that is minus cosec x into cot x. Now we want to take a sum using this type of formula, and we want to move our next slide. This is the nothing but the formula of the derivative for first method. So at least one or two sum, that is apply or ask in GTU based on this theory. So we write it first, the formula, that is limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. Suppose any value that is apply, that we can say that suppose f of x, and we want to find out f dash x. So here we can write f dash x equal to limit h tends to 0. This is the whole formula for the differentiation using first method. So we can write f x plus h minus f of x divided by h. So today's our whole session, that is based on this type of theory. So we write to our next sum. Next sum, that is f of x equal to x raised to h. So we write it f of x equal to x raised to n, and we want to find out the differentiation using first method. The first method, that is nothing but limit. First of all, write f dash x, and f dash x we can write limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. This is the first method differentiation, but we know without first method differentiation, this is the rule, x raised to n, our answer, that is n x n minus 1. So we want to prove that n into x raised to n minus 1 using first method. So here function, that is x raised to n, here f of x plus h, this means whenever value x that is come, x that is come, now our new function, that is x plus h, so replace x by x plus h. So we write it in this way, here limit h tends to 0, here x plus h, and here only x, so we convert into x plus h first, x plus h raised to n minus sign as it is, f of x, here f of x value, that is x raised to n, so we can write x raised to n and divide by h as it is. Now we want to solve this, here x plus h raised to n minus x raised to n and divide by h. Here we also know the rule of the limit, that is in our previous syllabus, limit h tends to 0 x plus h raised to n minus x raised to n divide by h. So we want to convert, first of all, our denominator in this way, x plus h raised to n minus x raised to n divided by x, and also subtract x. So ultimately our m, that is same, plus x and minus x, both x are cancelled out, and final value, that is h, as it is. Why we want to adjust this? Because of the rule we want to that apply using limit. Now we want to again simplify this equation. Here suppose we assume x plus h equal to z. For example, let we assume x plus h equal to z. So this x plus h becomes now z. Now if we assume any value, then our limit must be changed. Here h tends to 0, then in this way we want to change our limit. If we put here h equal to 0, then we can say that z tends to x. So we write z tends to x. Now if we change the limit, then replace all the variable with our new simplify equation. Here limit h tends to 0, that becomes now limit z tends to x. Here z tends to x, here x plus h we already assume as a z, so we can write z raised to n minus sign as it is, x raised to n as it is. Now just image here x plus h again, and x plus h we assume here z, so here z minus x. So our sum that becomes limit z tends to x, z raised to n minus x raised to n divided by z minus x. Our previous unit, that is unit number 2, we already cover such type of problem, limit z tends to x, z raised to n minus x raised to n divided by z minus x. Our answer when we apply the limit to this one, that is nothing but power, here n, and then x raised to n minus 1. That means power minus 1. When we apply the limit to z tends to x, z raised to n minus x raised to n divided by z minus x. So finally, we can get the result n into x raised to n minus 1. Now again, repeat, what is here f dash x? So ultimately, this answer, that is nothing but f dash x. So here f dash x, this is nothing but differentiation of x. So in this way, we can get our final result, that is f dash x equal to n into x raised to n minus 1. So we can write it, our answer f of x equal to x raised to n, then our answer, that is f dash x equal to n x raised to n minus 1. Now we move to our next question. Our next question, that is f of x equal to sin x. So we write it first, f of x equal to sin x. Now we want to solve this f of x using first method. So first method that we suggest, that f dash x equal to, we can write limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h, this is very basic equation for first method, minus f of x divided by h. So we write our formula, f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. Now our next step, but we obviously know that f of x equal to sin x, or basic rule that we know that differentiation of the f of x for sin x equal to cos x. So our aim to prove differentiation of sin x equal to cos x. So we move to our sum. So equal limit h tends to 0, write as it is, here x plus h, here f of x, so we convert x plus h form, so sin x becomes sin x plus h. So we write it sin x plus h minus as it is, here f of x, here sin x as it is, so we can write sin x and divide with h. Now we want to simplify it, because here sin x plus h, here minus sin x, but we rule of the trigonometric, that is sin minus sin. The rule suggests that sin minus sin, the rule, that is nothing but, first of all write it, limit h tends to 0, and sin minus sin, the rule, that is nothing but 2 cos sin. In bracket we want to add the theta, and second one we want to subtract the theta. Here theta, that is x plus h, so we can write x plus h, this is called theta 1, and add the theta, that means theta 1 plus theta 2, so we can write again plus x. So this x plus h, that is theta 1 plus x, that is nothing but theta 2, and for subtraction x minus h minus x, this is nothing but called subtraction with divide by 2, this is nothing but 2 cos x plus h plus x divide by 2 into sin x plus h minus x divide by 2, and all divide by h we can represent as it is. Now we want to again simplify our numerator. So here limit h tends to 0 as it is, 2 cos, here x plus x becomes 2x plus h divided by 2 into sin, here plus x and minus x both are cancel out, and remaining value, that is only h by all divide by h, that we replace as it is. Now again we want to more simplify our numerator. Here 2 cos 2x plus h, and divide by 2, that goes to both the side, so 2x divide by 2 plus h divide by 2, so we can write it equal limit h tends to 0 2 cos, only remaining term, that is x because 2 and 2 are cancel out, plus in here remaining term, that is h by 2 into sin h by 2, and here all divided by h as it is. We know the limit problem when sin theta divided by theta, that is limit theta tends to 0 sin theta divided by theta equal to 1. So in this way we want to convert our sum in this way, here sin h by 2, but here h, so our aim to convert same theta here, because here theta, here theta, here theta, that is h by 2, so we must same concept h by 2 to our denominator side. If we divide by 2, that becomes h by 2, but rule, that is must be multiply with 2. So ultimately our aim, that is satisfy here h by 2 and here h by 2. Now we want to more simplify. So that becomes limit h tends to 0. Here just look at here 2 and here 2, both are cancel out, and remaining value, that is cos x plus h by 2. Here sin h by 2, and in denominator side again h by 2, we write in this way, multiply sin h by 2 divided by this h by 2, right, in this way. Now time to apply the limit to our sum. Here h tends to 0, that means put or replace 0 by h. So here cos x plus 0 by 2, that becomes cos x plus 0 by 2, that becomes 0. Now apply limit to our second one, limit h tends to 0 sin h by 2 divided by h by 2, this is nothing but the rule, that is whenever limit theta tends to 0, sin theta upon theta becomes 1. So ultimately this is called 1, and again we want to more simplify, that is cos x plus 0.